Welcome back to the new professional StarCraft 2. Let me introduce to you, in the blue, the proud owner of a barracks, a lot closer to his opponent's base than what you might consider his own. It is the Admiral. It's GuMiho. And heading slightly to the left, we have, unbeknownst to him, getting cheese in game number one. It's the People's Terran. The most relatable, it's Cure. Best of three, TVT. And honestly, I think these two are the most interesting Terrans. Oh my God, he's just, okay, never mind. Jimmy, how many? Just, what are we at? What? 1,165 likes on this cast, on this video, on this cheese. And I'll cast another series. And I'll probably do it anyways. But thank you for watching. Hopefully you've had a good day so far. And hopefully watching Cure build a bunker next to a barracks that just floated into his main. Like, what's the point of this? Oh, maybe he was hoping he didn't have vision so he could do marauders. But otherwise, you could have just... If you were going to go You know what? I'm not here to criticize. I'm here to commentate. And right now, there's not... He keeps canceling. He canceled and restarted the Reaper. So now he's keeping him at home. The SCVs are fighting it out. The workers striking at each other. And now behind it, GuMiho does have a cyclone on the way from the factory that he's hidden in a similar location on his own main base. The SCV citizen's arrest absolutely slaughters him. And did Cure did scout the edge of GuMiho's main, which means GuMiho is gonna get away with it. Did he ever build anything out of it? Currently GuMiho has no units, but we're off to a rambunctious start. As these two players, GuMiho is one of the most creative Terrans, whereas Cure is whatever the opposite is. Oh my God, everyone dies at the end. He kills the SCV, loses the Reaper to the Cyclone. So Cure is the Terran I think everyone should play like. He knows what works. He's not gonna sit there microing Marines and Marauders when he could be making a few mines. And oh my God, never mind. Enough pontificating. We need to talk about something. It's a GuMiho game. I didn't know. Well, that's not for advanced ballistics. Fusion! Core! A Battlecruiser rush after a proxy rack cyclone play. GuMiho comes out swinging. The cheese is strong, it's sharp. But is it gonna be good enough to catch Cure off guard? We will see. As he's already got another CC, starts up Banshee, because I think it's kind of out of the realm of comprehend. Like, he's not gonna, where is his starport? Huh, it's right there, the most obvious. I'm looking around the map, the barracks lord here is just kind of wandering around as it does. Very hard to actually deal with. You have to manually press the lock on. Cure eventually does. What a mess to start. And Cure is making a Banshee, which of all the myriad options for dealing with battlecruisers, that is not one of them. It's essentially the only thing he could have chosen. I guess siege tanks aren't so great either, but a Raven is on the way, but Interference Matrix requires an upgrade. The battlecruiser is halfway done, and Cure has no idea. This is one of those, like, it's so committed, it's... An SCV comes out to save the barracks. He starts the Yamato Cannon. It's not just gonna be one. That was just the beginning. The fusion core is spinning up. And I think the Banshee is gonna get in moments before the battlecruiser jumps. Let's go to the Cure cam. All right, he's got three CCs. He's looking for things. He gets in looking for the third, maybe poking. All right. There's a... Reactor factory. That's where the factory was. Couple cyclones. More cyclones. Oh my God. What is that? Oh my God. So he still knows nothing. He's still rallying to the main like something's gonna happen. Okay, we gotta know. The battle cruiser is on its way across. GuMiho has successfully hidden it. He completely obliterated that Banshee.
Additional supply depots.
Cure is looking.
Command center.
Oh my. And wait a second. The battlecruiser! Oh, a scan. GuMiho wondering if he needs to jump. So we should be seeing interference matrix on the Raven. No, without interference matrix, the Ravens don't really have many options. My auto turret is good, but it's not going to stop the cruisers. The barracks is still hanging out. As GuMiho, not a big fan of barracks in general. Battlecruiser just strafing the Marines here. Auto turret slapped down. Cyclone trying to chip away. Wow, he doesn't care. And he jumps. Oh my god, GuMiho. This is not a Zerg. There's plenty of damage coming out. He loses the first battlecruiser, which is, you know, and now there's Vikings. He's got Yamato Cannon online. He can turn and fire on that Viking, but this is... That wasn't the Viking. He gets one of the siege tanks. He wants to come in with the Cyclones. He will save the second cruiser, and he's building more. He's committed now. Third command center is on location. But the Admiral may be jumping the gun a bit there. Actually, not jumping at all. That was the problem. As the first battlecruiser, very important, not loss. But he loses it, and I think that gives Cure a lot more breathing room. It's not... This is kind of an incredible build. I have no idea. The only saving grace is I think Cure is kind of trying to return to sanity, whereas GuMiho is so out there right now, he's gonna get away with it. He's got Blue Flame. He's got Hurricane Thrusters for the Cyclones on the way, the speed upgrade. He's continuing Battlecruiser production. He's at two. We'll see if he adds any more. Yamato, of course, is done. Another cruiser. He's going Hellclone Cruiser. GuMiho. Well, I mean, Cure may be the people's Terran, but GuMiho is a people pleaser here. Cure, of course, the Terran that you all should aspire to be, but GuMiho, the Terran you actually are. A Bronze League hero at the top level. And he's playing like it. What if we just proxied everything and went Battlecruiser? And a bunch of Cyclones. Can you do that? Well, here we are. Thing is, Kier has his production tab halfway across the screen. Getting the upgrades. He's trying to go Marine Tank like a normal build here. And if he builds too many Marauders, like, how many Vikings? He's had six Vikings. The Battlecruisers have not been getting much efficiency. Usually, ideally, he doesn't know that Cure doesn't have Interference Matrix. That's also a key part of this. Hurricane Thrusters doesn't help too much, one, when they're not done, and two, with Concussive Shells. So Cure up 20 supply here. The Battlecruisers, he's boosting the Medivacs. Yeah, this is... Oh, it feels like a whole lot of Cure trying things, and then... I'm GuMiho trying things, and then Cure just slapping him across the face for his insolence. Alright, those are Terran units. They don't die so easy. Well, Cyclones do. Quite brittle. Yeah, that ain't gonna work out. The Battlecruiser's on location. Wait a second, there's no anti-air. And by that... Did he just dodge a Yamato cannon with a medevac? Impressive. Indeed he did. Did he get... Yeah, still no interference matrix, but GuMiho doesn't know that. So he still has to respect the Ravens. More starports, more Vikings on the way. GuMiho only halfway through his 1-1 upgrades. That's quite a scary army. The battlecruisers are not here. Counter scan from Cure. The command center wandered off. Battlecruisers are on the other side of the map. So unless he's gonna jump back into the fray, which is ill-advised, GuMiho just kinda bleeds out a command center there. So not the ideal usage of a command center. Hellion's trying to come in. Siege tank gets a few hits off. Battlecruisers have arrived though, and Vikings do not have tactical jump. Blasting away the Vikings. The rest of the air army's on its way back, killing a surprising amount, well, not that surprising amount of SCVs. Jumps back, trying to intercept the army. Barely takes any damage on the battlecruisers. GuMiho expanding to the north side. Fusion core on the way for Cure. Maybe thinking battlecruisers himself. He'll have the Viking count. Right now, GuMiho clearly trying to avoid Cure more than the reverse. and the constant scans to keep track. Aliens, but a single marauder. Concussive, three more join up. Here's a 70 SCV, 69, nice enough. More scans. How many orbitals are we sitting on? Only three apiece. There hasn't been a lot of space to get those extra orbitals. Units are paramount here. Vikings being added in for GuMiho. GuMiho was able to take on Maru in the GESL with his Battlecruiser control. Though Maru did seem... I think Cure as well. Well, the key to Cure is he does the correct thing. A lot of Terrans, I'm looking at you, Maru, I'm looking at you, Beyond, I'm especially looking at you, Clem, will win despite their unit composition. They will micro those Marauders and Medivacs so well that they'll still take great fights and make it look good. But Cure works smarter and not harder. GuMiho is just like the crazy-eyed guy in the corner that is a danger to himself and others, and it's unclear. Which one more so? So you don't really, like, it's a dangerous fight. But yeah, Cure over here with a solid, stable unit composition, better upgrades, overall better economy, especially now. The siege tank count is damn high. The battlecruisers are to the south side, trying to find an opportunity. GuMiho still has a dozen SCVs idle on his semi-hidden base. Which, it's going to be a meaningful one, as Kira has been continually scanning the more obvious bases. The ones that he has, as well. Advanced Ballistics is nearly completed. Using that air superiority with the Liberators in order to drive a siege line back. Caduceus Reactor! Thank you, Kira! Thank you! The Medivac Double Energy Regen upgrade, replacing Rapid Reignition Thrusters. Kira had it queued up. After Advanced Ballistics. No Yamato, because of course he doesn't have any battlecruisers. Plus 3 ground weapons, plus 2 ship weapons, but 2-2 for GuMiho. The base will be spotted. You're diligent about scouting throughout this game. GuMiho's been all over the place. Cure just trying to return to some semblance of sanity. GuMiho not letting him so far. The battlecruisers, still. I think they're trying to catch maybe, but he's keeping them off to the side so they don't get scouted, and maybe he gets lucky and catches a Doom Drop. It appears Cure's intent, though, is to outright win a fight. He's not trying to avoid the army of GuMiho outright, but instead take a winning fight against it, which is a more reliable, if more difficult, way to go about things, because that is a lot of 15 siege tanks. It's going to be a very technical experience picking that apart. The battlecruisers are spotted. Still no interference matrix is the only missing part here. He jumps forward onto the tanks. And now that's on cooldown for a little over a minute. But the tanks of GuMiho still not sieging up. You gotta be careful about your army supply at this stage of the game as well. GuMiho has 83 workers, which means his army supply is slightly lower. What an interesting game to start things off. I have no idea how it ends, though. I'd say Cure has the better army, but if he goes the wrong way, there's just not that much anti-air for GuMiho. He's got 19 Vikings, 5 clones, and 3 battlecruisers against 29 Vikings. And plus 2 ship weapons is done. Anti-armor missile, even a few Liberator hits. Cure should win the air war. It's just the Cyclones being able to add some anti-air on the ground. There's only 4 Marines, by the way. Right, Akir's upgrading plus 3 infantry weapons and armor, and he's only got, like, 10 bio units. Why not, though? But his army, 29 Vikings, going to double-digit Liberators. The Battlecruiser's still trying to engage. Jumps away. Did he use Yamato? He did not. But the Viking fleet of GuMiho... He's got 1-2 in the air. 2-1 for Cure. So, I'm not actually sure how those upgrades face off, but the air army is clearly better here for Cure. An anti-armor missile could change everything. I'm surprised he didn't use it. Microing back, but the Liberators themselves... Oh my god! Cure absolutely sweeps away every one of those Vikings. and claims total victory in the skies. The Vikings hit the deck and annihilate the tanks. And cure just a decisive victory for the people's Terran. The Admiral leading his ships into an ill-fated engagement. This entire game has felt like an ill-fated engagement for GuMiho. He's been clever. He's avoided persecution from the superior army of Cure, but Cure finally pinned him down. The battlecruisers are still trying to avoid things, but GuMiho has not really won a fight this entire game, and that makes it very hard to win the war. Another fleet of Vikings. 12 versus 33 is the total, but Cure is splitting his Vikings. He has so many of them. A Liberator picking things apart. Advanced ballistics technically done, not that it matters much here. The scans across the board. 5 orbitals now for Cure. Is tactical jump online? Technically it is, but the Vikings are doing terrible, terrible damage. Knock down 2 battlecruisers before they can jump away. GuMiho, this is a math problem, and that problem has been solved. Cure is the antidote. Okay, well, not this time with the battle. I love GuMiho's. I love your gumption, son, but you're in way over your head. You can't just go battlecruisers into, I don't know, hell clones? At least not against Cure, who was the level-headed Terran in the room. But what a fun game. But does not bode well for GuMiho. All right, going in to game 2. Take your guesses on how many SCVs have been sent out. I kind of led you on. It was 0. I don't. But always fun to guess. I did enjoy it, though. Enjoyed GuMiho playing like a Bronze League hero against Cure, who's... There you go. There's your count of the Battlecruisers, guys. He didn't even get Interference Major. That wasn't even a particularly complicated counter. It was just enough on the ground to be a threat. And then, as soon as he saw GuMiho was committed to the air, more Vikings. Because the advantage you have in that scenario is mobility. You can hold on to your bases. Whereas GuMiho, with a more expensive and overall weaker army, could not. So Cure takes another base, maybe 2. Gets more upgrades, more production of the same units. More Vikings beats less Vikings. All right, Netflix seems to think so. Now, I would argue that the quality of the Vikings is relevant. You can't just keep making Viking shows and calling it Vikings when it's not Anyways. I digress. I think we've moved past the Vikings phase in media. No, I'm a big fan of the Vikings phase. I don't know what we're on now. There were zombies in my... This is important. So there were zombies. And then Vikings. I'm just basing this off of like the general trend of games and media overall. I'm not sure where we are now. I think we're back to just like general fantasy. It kind of feels like maybe like dystopian fantasy, but definitely not as strong of a trend for Vikings and zombies. I don't know. Maybe I'm not in the loop, but. And also, of course, just in my experience. Honestly, my favorite game right now, just aesthetically, and something... I like the beaver-based gameplay. Timberborn and Against the Storm. Go check them out. I don't care if those... They don't cost $60. They don't even cost close to $60. But if they did, they're worth it. Beaver-based gameplay. All right, what would you do for more wood? But both city builders, very different. Against the Storm, I think, is more suited for StarCraft players. Timberborn is just Factorio with beavers, kind of. Rimworld. Rimworld Factorio. Either way, both those games, incredible. Almost as good as StarCraft. Full recommendation. Stormgate needs beavers. I have spoken. That is my recommendation as well. I'll be passing that along. Where were we? Cyclones. How many? 2. And counting. Well, 1 for Cure, There's already two for Gumi. After that hectic experience, we're all gonna settle down. It's like a Reaper SCV guide so far. Alright. Interpure making up for... Honestly, I didn't feel like he needed it. I was very surprised to see no anti-armor missile. Though I'm not sure how the math works out. Anti-armor missile, very helpful for liberators. I'm not sure if it helps Vikings kill other Vikings in less hits, though. Because Vikings hit each other pretty hard. It can't hurt. I think it's probably better than one auto turret to anti-armor missile. It's not important. Math, we're not here to do math. Kier understands the very basic equation that more stuff counters less stuff. Very wise in that. So GuMiho goes completely the other direction and is now just going for a 2-rex marine medevac timing. I like the complete polarized shift here, which is about as far away from a battlecruiser rush as you can get. Instead of floating his barracks around like it's an overlord, he's actually making it the basis of his entire strategy here. Oh my god. Kira gets in with a Reaper. Did he see the medevacs? Ready. I don't think he did, or the Ravens would be in the main. Will GuMiho scan? That's the question. The scan may give it away, but also... Yeah, the scan in this scenario, a scan from Cure. Oh my god, he sees the barracks. He expects GuMiho to be defensive, but guess what? There's two medevacs in the back of your main. Cure fully bamboozled. Actually, a little late is GuMiho on... Oh, that siege tank, that siege tank. Oh, this is not going well. This is a interference matrix just barely after. But you can't boost when interfering. Oh, wow. This was a total disaster. Wow. That was... That could not have gone much worse. In fact, if Cure was in his base, GuMiho probably would have done better because he wouldn't have committed to the attack. But the fact that Cure kind of had to come back made GuMiho more bold. Far too bold, I might argue. And he loses everything. But now trying to take this forward position, Cure. There is interference matrix. The Cyclones, a scan, spots the army. The Cyclone's doing a great job here. Oh, he doesn't know about the tanks. He doesn't know about the tanks. There's two tanks, Cure, no! Ah! He has enough energy, but those are Stim Marines. He doesn't, I mean, this is, okay, wait. Tank about to come unsieged, it's taken down. Well, I guess it worked out. Another tank. Scan, counter scan. The Raven. Strong gust of wind, or even a weak gust of wind at this point. Take it out. Well, Marine's also better than wind. So, Cure, he won the fight, but then decided he would go for more. Which now leaves us in a very awkward spot, because GuMiho actually had 3 command centers earlier. He'll lose 10 SCVs. But GuMiho also has his upgrades on the way. He already has his production up. 5 barracks against 3. So Cure was on 2 base production. He just threw away his unit advantage. Why are there SCVs here? Man, don't worry about it. God, these two, so much more relatable than some of your other Terrans. And it's so much more fun to watch, in my opinion. Especially in mirror matchups. Wow. Okay, the boys have been pulled. The citizens arrest. You can't be here, siege tank. Only loses 3 SCVs. The rest are softened up. Well, the SCV repairing like it was meant to be here. And maybe it was. Viking comes in, just dies. Siege tank is in range. He's gonna drop again. There's nothing in the main to defend. He's coming back. Dropped out of the medevac. The battle will continue. GuMiho leaning on the advantage. He has the upgrades. Oh, loses. Oh my god, he does it! It lives! And that's gonna make it even more difficult. 11, 12, 13, 14 SCVs. Yeah, he got it with the siege tank before, but GuMiho pulls back. You're losing a whole lot of supply here. 20, he's still killing the Vendiascan. He's gonna try to move forward. Here comes GuMiho with some reinforcements, trying to deal with this, but he's gonna drop on top. Oh my, dropping the base here. And now moving back, trying to retreat. But Cure is running out of options. The Marines aren't doing so great here. Is he attacking his own sensor tower? I'm pretty sure he just killed his own sensor tower, right? Yeah, I'm reasonably sure that's what happened there. Not the ideal choice of target from Cure, but at this point, there aren't too many good choices. It's gonna take, he's dropping mules at a base that is currently burning. I don't even think he's repairing at the moment. Gonna split and stim a half second, well, 2 seconds before plus one armor completes. Actually, it's enough. GuMiho pushed back for now. Now, oh my god, Cure anticipating the drop boosts into his main, while GuMiho goes completely to the other side. So Cure clearly reacting to a ghost drop at this point. I don't mean the unit, just the idea of it really stressed him out. But GuMiho just backed off and regrouped. What a hectic game, but GuMiho the clear victor ever since Cure overextended. He was able to lean on his extra production, his extra economy, and as long as GuMiho doesn't fly into Cure's Marines that are so patiently waiting, he should be in position, especially, wow, 2-2 about to finish. GuMiho showing he's a Terran of many talents. I don't know if the Battlecruiser Rush was considered talented, but if we did consider that talented, even though it did kind of horribly, then a Terran of many talents, as right now he's clearly far ahead, both in upgrades, supply, bases, I clickbait appeal. I don't know. Would you rather, if I'm going to clickbait this series, okay, I don't know how Jimmy decided to do it, but would you rather be Cure's middle of the road marine tank Terran strategy or GuMiho's wild Terran builds on the new patch? TM. I think I already know which one it's going to be so far, unless something incredibly hectic happens. Cure's not dead yet. So if this game goes on more than a couple more minutes, because I won't lie to you, I value my honest assessment. So the key is not always giving your honest assessment. Like, I might think GuMiho is going to win this game in about a minute and a half, based on the fact he's going to max out with 2-2, and there's no reason to be sitting at home, especially when Cure's going to try to take a fourth. So, like, 13 minutes, GuMiho comes across the map, boom. Easy win. But you don't say that, because that's boring. You say that, and either one, you're wrong, and you look dumb. Two, it kind of kills all the drama. So don't say those things out loud. Edit that in post. We'll cut that entire part out, and we'll pretend like it's not obvious that GuMiho is a huge advantage here. All right? Good. Thank you. Oh, either way, at this point, Cure holding on. 2-2 about to finish. He's got options. He's got potential. GuMiho does have some advantages here. Most of them. But with 3-3 on the way and he's maxed out, no reason not to head forward. Plus one mech weapons about to complete for GuMiho. 2-2 gonna finish up for Cure. We'll see if GuMiho waits till his 3-3, but no fourth base means that GuMiho is kind of tightening the noose here. As the economy is clearly, well, not so clearly in his favor, I guess. The worker count is close enough. But the main base and the natural will be mining out very soon. They've already begun. Alright. Well, GuMiho, he's trying to contain both sides. At least one siege tank in the back. Plus three weapons is done. Plus three armor on the way. GuMiho backing off yet again. This is allowing Cure to potentially take his fourth. Concave looking good for now. GuMiho bringing everything together. But if Cure is able to take his fourth and a couple good fights, he actually does get right back into this. TVT is quite a finicky beast, where you can set up all your moves, but if you make the wrong one, it can be a total disaster. Well, here we go. Something of a base trade. Cure on the other side with some of his army. Is it enough to break through? I don't think it's going to be enough to deal with the reinforcements and the multiple siege tanks already set up, but Cure does take the supply lead. The standoff will continue. Is he actually... He cancels a command center with just three marines. The siege will continue. Cure? There's still four siege tanks down there. GuMiho got plus one mech weapons. Both them working on plus two. Cure has a slight advantage, actually. If we get there, the siege tank's just blasting away at the planetary. Probably spending more money than he's gaining from it, but he really can't afford to give up this location. A couple Vikings will deny the medevacs in the sky. And Cure, he's trying to run out the clock on 3-3, but it's getting more and more difficult. GuMiho not willing to risk his army in a potentially disastrous fight, but slowly chipping away. Yeah, this is a much safer bet, as long as you're willing to risk a crazy base trade, which it looks like Cure is trying to do, and is probably his best option at this stage. Oh god, five siege tanks in range, and the planetary falls! With it, Cure's on his last economic legs. All right, where do we go from here? He's gonna go through the rocks, try to hit GuMiho's third. Scans across the entire map. They're everywhere. Sensor towers as well, but GuMiho, he pulls the boys. The tanks aren't quite siege. He's gonna fight into the siege tanks. Oh, the boys in the front. GuMiho, just enough marines left over. It was a devastating fight. But Cure loses all his tanks and many of the medevacs. And of course, obviously the marines. More siege tanks taking their many pounds of flesh on the way across. GuMiho almost done with a fusion core. I have my suspicions on advanced ballistics. But Cure drags GuMiho into a devastating fight. The problem is GuMiho can afford to replace those units, whereas Cure... Well, mules are quite a thing, I guess, but... Cure will not die. Another command center will try to land. GuMiho can't seem... And this is historical... Oh, wait, he is just... What? Those are tech labs. He builds a bat. Oh, this is what. Wow, GuMiho truly is the Terran every. Like, he. Cure is the Terran you should be. GuMiho is the Terran you are. He's like, well, I'm ahead. I'm not quite winning. I guess we'll just go Battlecruiser. And it's not even a bad idea. It's just. He's giving Cure a small opportunity to get back into it while he's transitioning into Battlecruiser. But that's so many siege tanks. He's gonna... Wait, can he just drop? Anyways, the Vikings. But the Vikings are shot down on the way. Cure just... He's been so far behind for so long. These fights have not gone great for GuMiho. In fact... Well, he's lost a few more minerals. 235 marines. But... Is this gonna be a Battlecruiser GG? Or is GuMiho just going to close it out first? You see, this is why it's dumb to call games so early. Just to break the fourth wall for a minute more. Cure is one of the best players at not dying. It's like when you stack him up against... Get him out! Get him out! And get the Battlecruisers in! When you stack him up against like a Maru or a Serral, yeah, it's... It's gonna look a little tougher, but against almost literally anyone else, Cure, he just makes the highest percentage plays. I'd be terrified. If Cure had the micro of Clem, he'd probably be number one in the world. I'm pretty convinced of that. But unfortunately, sometimes things just don't go quite perfect. the battle cruisers doing even more than the siege tanks could. He's chipping away at the siege tanks on defense. The tank line, GuMiho dropping mules to repair. Yamato cannon online. That one works a little quicker, and here we go again. I really thought, well, it appears GuMiho is gonna find a way to go battlecruisers in every game. Okay, oh my, well, and lose them. But the problem still remains for Cure. He can't easily hold this location. He's hanging on. How many battlecruisers on the map? He just stopped building battlecruisers because, yeah, it doesn't make much sense to just go battlecruiser here. Another base trade attempt. How much is back at home? GuMiho swinging back with a whole bunch of Marines. A planetary on the front line, though. And the Marines from the back. Siege tanks on either side. The Marines will be obliterated, but Cure just doesn't have enough left over. What a series. Oh my god, so many dead Marines. And we're not done yet, as GuMiho strikes back. Oh my god. I'm really not a huge fan of mirror matchups, or casting mirror matchups. I do find them to feel a little rock, paper, scissors-y. But it feels like both these players are bringing rock and paper, or scissors and rock, and they're just throwing them at each other. And those are the best, like, I find mirror matchups outside of the best players are actually have a lot more potential, even though Kira is one of the best. He does struggle in TBT. So every time the caveat of actually Kira is top five in the world. Yes, yes. Actually, Kira is still in the GSL while Maru and Bien are not. Yes, okay, okay. And there's a reason for that, but this is one of my favorite TVT series. Oh, it's brutal. And a lot of fun. It feels like my ladder games where someone... Now, I feel like Cure in my ladder games where I'm just over there trying to make Marines and tanks like a normal person. And then suddenly battlecruisers are jumping in. And it's not even good. Like, he's not even doing a good job with the battlecruisers. Why are you going battlecruiser? That last game, GuMiho just loses. He gets 3 starports, a fusion core, Yamato, and then just loses the battlecruisers and doesn't bother with anymore. Like, it didn't even work. But all roads lead to battlecruisers and Bronze League heroes. And apparently, when the Admiral is involved. It does outline how hard it is to end the game. Against the defensive posture. Thought the SCV might actually die. Is this a 1-rex expand in TVT? Oh, that's a bold move, Cop. See if it works out for him. Because it's a bold move because in TVT, having even a little bit of a tech advantage can be a game-winning move. Of course, we're on Site Delta, pretty long rush distance, and there's a ramp up to the high ground, which is a key part for defending against early shenanigans. All right. A bunker is required, essentially. Otherwise, you die. There's a chance he runs by the bunker when he realizes there's only one unit in it. We will see. Bunker spotted. Gonna try the high ground. Should be pretty obvious. Grenade thrown down. No, sir. This is private property. Got another clone on the way, GuMiho, with the first one here, as he did get the factory. Wait, did he get the factory quicker? No. Just a Hellion from Kier. And a Raven. We'll see. It looks like he's angling for a higher tech push. He should know based on the bunker. I mean, he saw the command center timing, so. A siege tank Raven push may be in order. GuMiho gets pretty. Oh my god, creepers are so annoying. Why? Just throws it out there. Marginally a minor inconvenience for the SCVs. GuMiho going back. I mean, the two racks medevac drop worked. Cure was caught very flat-footed there. Surprisingly effective. It worked. And then, if you remember, Cure lost it horribly. I mean, GuMiho lost both medevacs and all the marines, killing like three SCVs. But eventually the drops were enough to give GuMiho the lead. Well, most of the lead was because Cure overextended super hard, but the drops had more success past the first one. Interference Matrix is on the way. 2-3 Ravens? Okay. Cure? Really leaning into them. Whereas GuMiho, sticking with his guns and his drugs. Yes. He'd fit in with my neighbors pretty well. Stim and medevacs were dropping. Double barracks at the low ground there? Interesting. GuMiho's gonna have his third barracks. So another key point of last game was GuMiho having all his production up. That's the hardest part of all Terran matchups, but especially TVT, is when do you add your production on? Because it's a big investment that takes a while to pay off. So the timing is very important. Oh, here we go again. Cure, you gotta think. You gotta use your brain head. Oh no, here we go. And there's just nothing, deja vu. I've just been in this base before. Nothing in the main, and the Marines are running free. He sieges up the tank, but he should be able to kill it before it fires a shot. Gets it. And Cure, somehow, some way, will fall for the same thing twice. He wouldn't do it again. GuMiho says, watch me. And now he's going to lose all his Marines and probably both medevacs. So, again, a good start that turns into complete annihilation. So, it appears neither player learned from their mistakes in the previous game. And we are destined to repeat history. So, the way this ended, if you can remember, like 16 minutes ago, was Cure eventually had the better army and then kind of threw it away into a poor attack, which led to GuMiho maintaining an advantage for most of the rest of the game. So we'll see. This time around, though, GuMiho is the one who wants to get aggressive. That scan is a bit suspicious. He's going to lead with the clone. Well, that was a dumb idea. That was terrible. That was just straight up very not good. He knew he had interference matrix ready. He scanned and saw the Ravens. He saw the interference matrix on his medevac. So I have no idea what GuMiho was trying to accomplish, unless he was trying to accomplish an efficient loss of all of his units there, in which case, nailed it. I'm going to go ahead and guess that wasn't the overall intent, though. He's now going to try from a different angle. Looks like he's going to drop the natural, which, amusingly, Cure has nothing there. Though he's not too far away. Is there enough energy for another interference matrix? Yep. The Marines are doing pretty well. 10 SCV kills. He's targeting more. Kind of struggling with the targeting a bit, but 13 SCVs down. GuMiho is going with the just continue being aggressive and maybe he'll make a mistake so large that I can capitalize on it. It's kind of working though, because Cure is really struggling to get his infrastructure up. GuMiho already has plus one. He's going to finish plus one armor. Cure's down 13 SCVs. GuMiho's comfortably mining from his third. So the violence of action, the continued aggression, even though it's going so poorly, GuMiho's lost almost double the minerals and almost three times the gas. But in terms of the state of the game, he's actually doing just fine here. GuMiho just YOLOing it. GuMiho is such a ladder player. Oh my god. I hate playing against these kind of players. I'm sure Kira does as well. It's like, oh my god, that attack was so dumb. Why am I struggling so much? I had all the right units. I had the right army come. I was even in the right spot. I microed well. Why am I behind? Because GuMiho has been recklessly greedy, both with his attacks and with his, just his macro. He built up his production. He has nothing in the main. He's got no turrets. He's barely acknowledging that Kira could do a counterattack. He is just continuing to be aggressive, and it's continuing to work because the margin for error for Kira is so small. If he makes any mistakes, he loses SCVs because GuMiho's sitting at in his base, whereas Kira has to win the fight on his side and carry it over to the other, which gives an advantage to GuMiho as long as he doesn't lose all of his army and he continues production back at home. He's going to have 2-2. I think GuMiho pulled back on the aggression at the right time. Right as he confirmed he did economic damage, he knows the Ravens were low on energy. He focused on keeping Cure at bay without losing any more units. So important. So important. So now GuMiho has a 2-2 advantage. He's going to have a fourth base quicker. It's looking very similar to the previous match, where Cure just doesn't have any control over the situation. Alright, we're going to compare. This is the mini-map. Here is GuMiho chasing things out. You know what? And now, here is Cure. Oh, it's so sad. But Cure, one thing he does well is build plenty of units. He's maxed out at about the same time. He's going to have a little more army supply. His upgrades are behind, but not so much so. And he's got those three Ravens. And they got near full energy now. So there's a very realistic possibility for Cure to win a decisive engagement. But he's got to pick that timing perfectly. As GuMiho, he doesn't even need to win a fight. He just needs to not lose. Because he can build way more stuff. A scan. I don't even know if he's scanning for Battlecruiser. He knows GuMiho too well. Maybe trying to make him suspicious that he's doing a drop. He scans the army there. It's hard to hide anything from the prying eyes of the Orbital Command. Two starports on the way. Cure may go Battlecruisers himself. Or just Raven. He's just trying to get air control. He gets his fourth. Oh my god, GuMiho is walking in a very, very dangerous place. The Valley of the Shadow of Siege Tanks. GuMiho and Kier both mags. GuMiho 3 CCs on the way. He's not spamming starports now, though. Instead, he's just focused. Is this the one game he doesn't go Battlecruiser? He's trying to drag Kier into a fight. Kier in the center of the map. He just picks up whatever he can, drops into the main, finds the starports, by the way. That's important info. The drop is kind of strung out, so it shouldn't do too much damage, but once again, he's in the base, so that means SCVs will die. Scrambles the siege tanks and will just completely clean up this army. It's on hold position, getting gunned down by Cure. But the rest of the army has dropped into the main. Cure's meticulous dismantling of that army doesn't matter when he loses his production. The siege tanks hit the planetary. He actually right-clicked on the planetary. Bit of a mistake there, but the main base is being gutted. I can't tell who's winning this. He scrambles one of the siege tanks. Anti-armor missile marines. The entire army will be cut down. But it looks like he got the orbital there. Cure loses his fourth, though. Yet again, GuMiho outright loses the battle in terms of, well, this one I'm not actually sure was so bad. But GuMiho loses a whole lot of supply. And Cure is able to clean things up. But Does he have any hope of coming across the map? Well, killing three siege tanks definitely helps. It's 2 tanks to 10. 10! Well, this is it. This is your moment. +2 vehicle weapons. About to complete. A huge upgrade for siege tanks. The Marines gun down the Ravens. They've been so effective so far, but the tanks are moving forward. +2 mech weapons done. This is the push. This is do or die for Cure, as he has only 43 SCVs back at home. But plenty of medevacs. He's got tank superiority. GuMiho gonna keep throwing Marines into the fray. His production is off the charts, or at least it makes the Y-axis very difficult. The army value heavily in favor of Cure. But GuMiho has a lot of ground he can give up. One interference matrix, Marines. Cure still bashing through. That's a planetary there. More Vikings on the way, starting to whittle away at the air superiority. Cure only has 2 Vikings with this, and they're already bruised. GuMiho doesn't need this base. He's got more to work with. He's got more command centers. The planetary is just obliterated by the tanks. The starports will be taken out, some of the Vikings gunned down, but Cure, his momentum is starting to wane somewhat. There are plenty of Marines on the way for both sides. More Ravens in production for Cure. He doesn't have many minerals, so why not? I think he maintains some of the starports there. GuMiho struggling to pick a fight here. It's 3-3, but the another key point is the +2 vehicle weapons. Those siege tanks hitting harder, and he has a lot of them. Scrambles both the siege tanks. No tanks in this fight for GuMiho. Cure trying to take a heads-up engagement. Vikings coming in. We'll kill some more of the Ravens. But GuMiho is pushed back again. Another siege tank on the high ground. Cure will take it out. And it the tank death ball here. Multiple orbitals. The Ravens are needed, though. Another tank on the high ground. The Liberators are going to be so important here. There's not that much air superiority. He finds kind of some dead space. But Cure is able to carry it through. His army is just too good. GuMiho loses the war of attrition. At the end of the day, Cure is able to carry it all the way across the map. I guess you can't just lose twice the Marines and triple the siege tanks and get away with it. I'm sure quite a frustrating match for Cure, but a victorious one. The People's Terran comes out ahead, 2-1 in an absolutely bloodthirsty, brutal back and forth, Terran versus Terran. I hope you enjoyed as much as I did. If you got the means and motivation, it'd be awesome if you could check out Patreon, YouTube membership, all that. Thank you for watching. Thank you to World Team League for putting on the Kung Fu Cup, and hopefully I made your day a little bit better. Good luck, have fun. I'll see you next time. Stay chill.